guys, and welcome to my channel GamingTheatre. Today I'm going to show you how to enable ray tracing on Unreal Engine 4. First of all, make sure that you have the latest NVIDIA driver version. This only works for GTX 1060 and above. I have the driver version 425.31 installed. Make sure you have a driver version that is newer or the same. So first, browse to your Unreal directory. Create a shortcut on your desktop for ue4editor.exe. Once you've done that, in the target field, add a space and add -dx12 space -raytracing and hit OK. Now launch Unreal Engine 4. Open up your project. In my case, I'm going to open up the game that I'm working on. Go to Edit, Project Setting, go to All Setting and search for Ray Tracing. Just check this box. It will ask if you want to enable another setting as well, which is required for ray tracing to work properly. Just click OK and then it restart now. I already have it applied, so I do not need to restart my editor. Once the engine relaunches, it's going to rebuild the shaded data. That can take a while. Be patient. I'm going to load up my level corridor. Okay, now that it has loaded up, go to this box and check Show FPS. Right now, ray tracing has been enabled, as you can see from this shadow. First, let me just disable all ray tracing effects. Okay, so now that I have disabled all my settings, now I get 40 FPS without ray tracing. Now to enable ray tracing, all you have to do is open up console, type r.raytracing and set it to 1. This will enable ray tracing. r.raytracing. Now if you type r.raytracing and this is grayed out, you either do not have the latest Unreal Engine version, or you do not have the latest NVIDIA driver, or you do not have a qualifying GPU, which is Pascal series GTX 1060 and above. Now let's see what the different settings of ray tracing do to our map and how it looks like. Ray tracing ambient occlusion is basically used to add ray traced ambient occlusion to the scene. If I set it to 1, to open up the console, just press the button that is below your escape key, type r.raytracing ambient occlusion, and if I set it to 0, you can see the shadows just became much softer. And if I set it to 1, the shadows become much harsher. At what cost? r.raytracing ambient occlusion 0. Right now the FPS I'm getting is about 45 FPS. If I set it to 0, the FPS just jumps to 75 FPS. So there's a huge difference. If I just zoom out and check the difference, are ray tracing and mirror occlusion 1, 38 FPS versus 55 FPS, so 20 FPS increase by disabling ray traced ambient occlusion. There is another option called r.raytracing reflections. This is basically used to add reflections. This is basically used to add reflection to materials which have roughness set to 0 and metallic set to 1. So it basically has the mirror effect. The reason why there is no texture getting displayed in this mirror is because I do not have material ray tracing enabled on materials. To enable ray tracing on materials so that your materials appear inside reflection, is to just open up console, type r.raytracing dot enable materials, space 1, enter. Now this will show materials inside ray traced shadow, although it caused the FPS to drop substantially. So 23 FPS versus 40 FPS, 20 FPS drop. r.raytracing dot enable materials set to 1. Right now it's showing this blue sky instead of the wall which should be displayed. This is because of our skylight. So in order to fix this, we can just search for skylight and just hit delete. And now it shows the room, although a bit dark. So let's just hit Control Z to bring back scale light, because we want to see the difference between different settings of ray tracing. Now let's see ray tracing. The other options here are global illumination. Wait, first let me just disable ray tracing reflection. Set it to 0 and hit OK, so that we gain our FPS back. R.raytracing global illumination, set it to 1. So that's like 30 FPS decrease. And I'm not sure if I see any difference between the two, but it just makes it unplayable. Let's go up and see if it made any difference there. R.raytracing global illumination, set it to 0. So no difference here as well besides FPS. Now there's another option called R.raytracing and shadows. Let's just hit 1, enter. From 40 to 25. It isn't that severe, but it's the FPS difference is there, definitely. Keep in mind I'm running on a GTX 1060, so if you have a higher end GPU it might run better. Let's see the effect of ray trace shadow. The ray trace shadows are currently enabled, set it to 0. You can see that we just lost the shadows that were coming off from these glass. And another difference is these handles. One, you can see that there is a shadow here now below this handle, as well as shadow difference in this area and this area. Keep watching, let me disable it. 0 versus 1. So this does not have that big of a performance impact. It makes the map look better, so if you want to enable it, you can. You gain 15 to 20 FPS. 10, 15 FPS. It's up to you to decide which setting you want to enable. Now, in my opinion, the most taxing on the hardware is ray traced reflections. Let's enable this and show you the impact of ray traced reflections. One. And right now you can see the FPS just dropped by 20, and anything that is even slightly rough, it's going to cost a huge reflection. So if you want to enable ray traced reflections, then you're going to have to disable even the smallest amount of roughness in materials that do not matter. For example, I said this a bit too rough, I guess. Okay, to show you the effect, let's just open this stair mesh up and open the texture that these stairs are using and set the roughness to 0 and see how badly the FPS drop. 23 versus 30. One thing about ray trace reflections is that it will give you better performance if you set the roughness to either 1 or 0. However, if you put the roughness at something like 0.5, the FPS decrease will be greater. As you can see, the FPS fell from 22 to 19. This is because when the roughness is 0, it only needs to just reflect back the environment. It does not need to do any complex calculations. When you set it to 1, it just completely diffuses light. So no complex calculations involved here either. However, when you set it to 0.5, it has to take into account how rough the material is, and then it has to take into account how many light photons the material has to absorb and how many light photons it has to deflect into how many different angles and at what angle. If you set it to 0, the FPS will increase. So you have to keep in mind that if you enable ray traced reflections, then you will have to make sure that you either use 0 roughness or use 1 roughness to ensure there is no great performance lost. Now if I enable each and every one of these settings, let's see how taxing the environment will be for my GTX 1060. Okay, every setting has been enabled except for global illumination. Global illumination is set to 0. And with all of these settings applied, I get 25 FPS with a lot of lights as well as complex structures and complex lighting applied on a GTX 1060. Let's hit play to check how it looks in game. So this is with each and everything enabled except for global illumination. Let me just disable ray trace reflections because they do not look good in this scene. Okay, so now this is only with shadows enabled. Ray trace shadows enabled. Hit play. Shadows enabled, 25. There's shadow from the railing, so the FPS are going down. Opening the door. This area has less shadows. As you can see, this type of shadow is what might cause an FPS drop. So this is how it runs with only raytraced shadows enabled and every other setting disabled. This is on a GTX 1060. Again, it's very impressive since GTX 1060 is very low level. That the developer does, the game can actually run pretty smoothly. Now let me just create a new project to showcase some other setting of Unreal ray tracing shadows. Let's look at this. Now again, the reflection that is only visible is the player as well as this. The reason why the mirrors are appearing black is because we have insufficient numbers of bounces. Let's just increase it by going to post process volume, go to ray trace reflection, max bounces. The greater you set it, the more bounces there will be. Since there are only two reflective materials, that is why the FPS do not suffer as much. If I disable this, enable, disable. 42 FPS, max bounces 10, 41, 42, 41. No noticeable difference because these are not complex. There seems to be an error if you increase the bounces too much. And of course, the FPS will decrease as well. And boom. Yeah. The FPS decreases a lot. So this is the power of ray tracing in Unreal Engine 4. And this is also how to enable it. This is basically a overview of ray tracing, how to enable it. Let's just set max bounces to 2 and hit OK. Let's set it 3, OK, and play. The FPS decrease are now not as low, but the environment isn't really that complex. But the fact is that it is running even at 30 FPS on a GTX 1060 is still amusing for me, at least. So this is with all the settings enabled, although I'm not sure that every setting has been enabled, because for some reason ray tracing has been grayed out. It might be because ray tracing is not allowed in open world games. I hope you guys like this video, and please do like, share and subscribe for more. See you guys later, bye.